How's it going, guys and girls? This is Ketchup and Mustard here. This is something very special today. We've not done this before, but we figured we would start a new, I guess, mini-series of MKX videos. Long story short, we really miss commentating, and the patch has hit. And, of course, we want to do an abundance of post-patch content, and we were watching Foxy stream. Foxy Grandpa was streaming the other day. We watched his archive, and he had a really, really good set against CR Sonic Fox. It was a first to 10, and it was Cryomancer versus Buzzsaw, two variations that were definitely changed since the patch, very significantly, and they gave an amazing demonstration of what these characters can now do. So, what have we decided to do, Jake?
We messaged Foxy and asked for his permission to take that first to 10 set and watch it back and commentate over it. So we know what happens. Obviously, we know the result. However, there's a lot to these matches. And we know that a lot of you guys might not necessarily have watched this. So we're going to commentate over this first to 10. We know the end result, but we can't remember exactly how the matches go. So it is going to be refreshing to us to watch again. Let us know what you think. We're going to commentate this first to 10 set. And hopefully, it'll be quite good to watch, because we miss commentating. This is a great opportunity to do so, and Foxy gave us permission to. So, hopefully you guys have fun with this, because we know we will.
Yeah, I mean, we're not going to talk about this too much before we get into it, because I do want to watch these matches. But it's basically that we haven't had a chance to do much post-patch content, because we've been incredibly busy. Do you want to move the microphone slightly away from your mouth as well, I think, Jake, just so that we can match up some of it? Audio-wise, this is a complete first for us, so I've done what I can to make sure that the audio is level, so you can hear the game, but you can also hear us. Please bear with us, because this is a long set. This is a very long set. But it's a good one, and this is hopefully the first of many sets like it that we will watch over and show you guys and commentate. So, without further ado, I think we're good to go. As you can see, it's a Twitch video, which is my little mouse here, and we're going to watch it. So we're going to sync up our play. We are on different computers, so we've got to sync it up. So on one, Jake, we'll go 3, 2, 1. So, he's invited Sonic Fox in. They're going to play together. This, again, was from Foxy's stream, so he's listening to music. I don't know whether, you know, we're even going to be able to advertise or whatever, because he's got his own music in the background, but like I said, this is pure gameplay. Buzzsaw, definitely very changed because of the Universal Loud changes. Cryomancer sub, the fact that he has been given tick grabs is very significant and has almost turned him into arguably the best grappler in the game.
Also want to quickly say, because this is Foxy's stream, we are going to put a link to his Twitch in the description so you guys can check it out, give him a follow, but let's get into it. Buzzsaw versus Cryomancer.
So almost immediately, Foxy's going to try and establish that sort of low hat game to kind of keep him in check. But Sonic Fox, he's going to hit confirm. Nice, catches him with the back two. And that's in the corner is going to turn to a restand into something that is more than a 50-50. You know, don't quote me on that, but it's dangerous stuff.
And that's a big change to Sub-Zero now, using the Shatter to keep himself safe. You can basically put Shatter at the end of a lock to get that safe mind game, especially in comparison with the grab. That now he's got the knockdown, the grab's looking super scary, especially if it ticks, especially off the back three as well.
Now, I really like that Sonic Fox goes for, he does the hammer into an immediate forward dash into a back three. That seems to time in with almost all of Cryomancer's meaties, where you do the hammer splat into one forward dash into meaty, and that sets up really nicely for a tick grab. Just like that.
Nice.
That's going to be big now, damage.
It's like, the tick grabs are definitely what Sonic Fox has picked up Cryomancer for. I know he said before he even got his hands on the patch, if Cryomancer can tick with his grab off of X amount of things, I'm going to main Cryomancer, and that's exactly what he's done. And just like that, another new... I don't think that's quite max damage, because this is, like, his day two Cryomancer, but still, you know, the consistency is there, and he's ending everything in the grab to get that same knockdown, so the Oki is always going to be dangerous.
And as you can see, that instant forward dash after a splat, that seems to tie in a meaty everywhere on screen, and they're very, very convincing game number one. So as sets tend to go, you will notice that these first few games will be both players basically feeding each other out, because Sonic Fox isn't going to have loads of experience with new Buzzsaw, and Foxy's not going to have loads of experience with new Cryomancer.
Yeah, so it's kind of adaptation as they learn, you're going to see it. And that's to us one of the main reasons we actually picked this set, was because when we were watching them back, just the speed in which each player like adjusted to these new changes was incredible. And that's exactly why this is the kind of set we want to bring you. So right here, I mean, I'm not sure, this is just Sonic Fox sending a message. So obviously, they're just waiting. This wasn't a super serious set, but they definitely ran it 210. So, you know, this isn't like diehard tournament mode, so don't take it as such. But still, no one wants to lose, so they're still playing to win.
Yeah, for sure. I actually think this is quite a fun match to watch as well, because Buzzsaw very heavily changed as well, where he gets access to new BMBs. He's able to now combo into the straight hat without bar and can juggle a dive kick off that. So it's going to up his damage quite significantly.
Oh, nice, nice read on the up hat. Oh, man, time is in with the hat coming back as well to get the spin. So a nice 23%, not huge damage, but it's something. And obviously the corner carry that Buzzsaw has always wanted to have is even more dangerous now.
Foxy tried to go for a little bit of a delay there, trying to catch the grab. Didn't quite get it. Sonic Fox is going to block that. And here we go, the sort of day one Buzzsaw stuff, you know, back two into low hat or back 2-2. However, Buzzsaw, much more dangerous now when you can do back 2-2 into straight hat and get a full combo anywhere on screen. Oh, nice,
oh, nice punish.
That's actually one of the benefits of Buzzsaw as well, actually. I think the forward one, I think the string is, being massively sped up, gives him a far much more consistent punish on that Sub-Zero back two.
I think that's back one, actually, is the...
is it back one?
Sort of like, yeah, it's the one where he sort of lunges his hand towards the air, but it still hits high, so it still hits standing opponents. It's also amazing, isn't it? Oh, neutral crouch just gone to the command grab. I wonder if that's a consistent thing.
Well, we'll find out if he does it more in the set. Oh, tries to go for... I'm not sure what that was. Maybe a down three?
Oh, no!
He uses a command grab. Grabbed out of the down one. The good stuff.
Also, one thing about the Cryomancer grab, deceivingly long range on it, especially in that kind of situation. If you meter burn it, you have the armor too. Overall, just a really dangerous move now.
Oh, they're trading pokes. And again, Sub-Zero sped up down one, makes that a lot more dangerous. Nice hit confirm into the grab. That could be death into a forward dash. And oh my god, regular spin. Foxy having nothing to lose. Catches the jump in anyway.
Combos the jump and punch into the teleport hat. Nice stuff there. 31% gets the low. Oh, gets hit by the up head.
Yep, and this is the Buzzsaw stuff, man. Getting those new combos in the corner, making the mix-up much more dangerous. Tries to go for the chip damage, and he's going to get tagged by the meteor and slide anyway.
Not quite sure why Foxy went for that. That wasn't going to chip out. Maybe he thought he'd get something after it, but Sonic Fox, you know, all he needed was chip there, and he got the meteor and slide, which has two hits of armor, so armor breaking, not even a possibility standing.
I'm pretty sure Kung Lao's X-Ray is plus on block, just not plus enough to deny armor, like Sonic Fox went for in that situation. But again, tries to punish it, doesn't have the hat, so I wonder how likely Sonic Fox is going to be to throw out the back two when he knows the hat's not on Foxy's head. He's not going to get a punish there, you know.
I see Foxy already making a read on these tick grabs and jumping out, because thing is, if he goes into the shatter, the jump is going to make it whiff. If he goes to the grab, it's going to whiff. And obviously, when you see it, that's you can start going for dive kick, you can start punishing it. So this is the kind of adaptation we were talking about. But right now, they're just trading armor for armor right now. Spends two bars to get the launcher.
Sonic Fox is definitely keeping hold of that bar. All he needs is one touch, and he can take him out. Tries to do regular grab. I wonder what that was for. Can I catch him with the anti-air anyway? Catches the back 3-3, but this is a male character, so the back 3-3 into Ice Ball isn't going to connect, and Foxy's going to do it. He's going to take the punish, and that's it. 1-1.
Fox might have thought it was just a little bit closer to the corner than he was, because it looked like it was going to connect, but unfortunately just a little bit too far away. I think the wake-up meter bone grab may have been a read on Foxy going in for a back 2, which would have caught it, but unfortunately it didn't work out for him. First hit gonna go to Foxy again.
Oh, nice.
Clean punish.
But that another bonus to Cryomancer, the assisted hit confirm ability with the 1-1-1.
But he's had that for a while.
It's just, no!
A missed input from Foxy, unfortunate stuff.
That
back
was
to the corner.
Definitely not intentional right there. So the Fox with the 1-1-1 pressure. I wonder if he can catch that airborne. That's why he's going for it as often. Here comes the mix again. Now Foxy's just gonna throw as many hats as possible. There you go. That's definitely an addition to the Buzzsaw arsenal. Just catching the double overhead and not having to spend bar anymore, just to confirm.
Oh, nice. Now the thing is, the Foxy grab game is one of his generally best tools. But the thing is, against a command grab, is it gonna be as effective? Especially when Fox is so good at taking grabs on reaction, and then the command grab's gonna catch him out there. Oh, catches him with a jump back
now.
That's a full jump in.
I'd like to point out something Sonic Fox did right there, which I think will be data for future games. When he sees low hat blocked, he's actually throwing out a command grab right there. And if it connected, he's gonna get a full combo on that. So Foxy's gonna have to be really careful when throwing those low hats point blank.
That's the grab, isn't it? You know, turning it into a launcher if you've got the bar is basically turning your command grab into a combo starter, which is unusual, but something we all have to understand now.
Recovering safely, but I mean, still in a bad situation. Speaking of which, Sonic Fox is going to get a nice confirm right there. That's actually nice damage. New BMBs right there.
Yeah, 32%, not bad at all.
Staggering the back three into pressure, and just like that, crazy good corner pressure, and it's one round apiece.
I'd say the biggest blow-up of the set so far is that Sonic Fox is wearing that old costume.
Quiet, you. Nothing wrong with Sub-Zero rocking those tracky bombs.
But guess another one. A nice chunky 36%, and again goes into the forward dash, but into a down three this time.
Well, it's going to be much easier for Sonic Fox to freely pressure Kung Lao now. The armored spin isn't as much of a thing, because so many of Sub-Zero's strings will advance forward. It's going to make that wake-up meteor band teleport.
Oh, wake-up forward jump, though.
Sorry, Fox. He's going for these really interesting max damage setups. I think that's definitely going to be some kind of tricky max damage. Oh, good trade, though. Sonic Fox is going to take it anyway. Oh, what a conversion. Nice.
That was nice stuff, though. I mean, to be fair, I mean, seeing Fox go for these two confirms, we're going to see him drop them. Like, this is like his, was it day two crime answer at this point? Like, I think this was a couple days ago, so the patch was still relatively new. So we're going to see him drop them, but the fact that they know these combos exist and they're trying to get the muscle memory in for it is super important, especially when you look at the SCR is next week. We've got, is it NEC coming up as well in the future? But there's a lot of money to still play for, so it's worth getting the muscle memory down.
It's definitely a good time to be a competitive player in North America. Foxy's going to take that grab. I mean, like, that's really... Oh, no, catches the overhead. Nice! Foxy's going to go for max damage. Knockdown once again. Easy 31%. Foxy right there. But he's going to get tagged anyway. And now this is all going to be Sonic Fox.
How's the corner pressure? Ends the grab, yes. It looks like the back 1-2 into grab is a really consistent way of getting the grab, regardless of how much gravity you've already used up. Nice confirm from Foxy, goes to the new B&B, ends it with a 2-1. Gonna try and chip him out from full speed. No, runs in for the grab. Nice read.
I think Sonic Fox wasn't gonna be a bit too antsy there to try and deal with that grab. Because I mean, look, he's sitting on 3 bars of meter. He's gonna be playing Cryomancer, so all he needs is one solid hit. But a nice read from Foxy. And again, using, I like the delayed string there just to get the hat to come back. I'm assuming if he went for something earlier, the hat wouldn't have been there. So we have to delay that time a little bit.
I wonder if the Meatman Ice Ball is going to destroy the low hat, though. Because we can see Fox throwing it out there at a range where Foxy normally does the low hat. So I wonder if that's actually a legit option at dealing with it. Oh, tries to confirm off the jump kick. Doesn't quite get it, but attempts it anyway. Or trading pokes again.
Lots of pokes, but Foxy's going to hit confirm. Get nice respectable damage. Does drop the confirm. Nice! Meterless anti-air spin.
Oh.
Splat. Now, the last time Foxy saw that, and again, that's what I was talking about, advancing strings, kind of making that teleport whiff, that's going to be a matchup changer, I think. And again, good thing for Sonic Fox broke that, because I'm pretty sure that might have been the round.
Train the down ones again. I mean, that's one of the buffs that Sub-Zero did receive, was a sped up down one, so going to be something you've got to respect a lot more now. Oh, runs under!
That was a good run under there from Foxy, trying to catch the anti-air. Doesn't get the combo, but I think just enforcing that anti-air is enough in that stage. He gets the knockdown, which is going to lead to grab, so that's not the end of the world.
Oh, tries to confirm. I don't think he quite recovered in time, though. Oh, trading.
I think there's a lot more trades in this matchup than I would be familiar with. And again, nice hit confirm. One of the new B&Bs where you're going to go into spin first, and then you're going to go into the straight hat. That's going to be a nice way to get corner carry and good damage.
I like how Sonic Fox is opting to do a lot more staggers, though, against Kung Lao, now that the meter burn spin isn't such a threat. And there's part of me thinks that Fox is almost deliberately taking the back three to make the grab whiff, but that could just be me looking a little bit too far into it.
Well, either way, that's going to be two games apiece right there. I think you can tell that, you know, although there's a lot of fundamental stuff going on here, the guys are both playing incredibly well, but there's a big element of newness. You know,
there is still unfamiliarity, and that's going to happen when the patch is as new as it was at this point.
Well, I mean, Foxy's been playing Lao for, you know, since launch, but the way you play Buzzsaw now, execution-wise, it's unlike anything Buzzsaw has seen before. You know, these are some tricky conversions that you need to learn if you want to use Buzzsaw post-patch.
But at the same time, you know, the combos might not be quite as difficult, but still, Cryo has, for the most part, all of his B&Bs have completely changed, so it's the same for him too.
Yeah, exactly. And there's the sit grab. Foxy's going for a couple of those neutral crouches, but currently, so far, he's been unable to actually punish them, even though he's actually got the crouch. So the read is there, but the execution currently isn't.
Oh, I think we're seeing Foxy go for the neutral crouches because so far the only real mids that we're seeing Foxy do in the neutral is a down one. You know, that is kind of his way of starting pressure point blank. And if you get hit by a down one, then that's not as dangerous. But obviously if he does his 1-1, you can stand up and punish it, which is something Foxy has always done.
Oh, Foxy's still confident he's going to take this round.
It might always have a teleport reaction. Doesn't have the bar to get anything more than just the grab though. Goes underneath. Oh, a bit of a read there. Oh, a dive kick. Cheeky stuff from Sonic Fox on the ropes, but has the bar.
Has him in the corner, catches the low hat, another one. Oh, and he gets hit by the meter band slide. Sonic Fox still in this, gets the wake up meter band teleport, and Foxy's going to take round number one of game number five.
I'm actually surprised that Fox pressed buttons there, because that teleport seemed like the most obvious thing in the world, but sometimes that's exactly what you need.
Yeah, I agree completely. Oh no, he tries to grab. Definitely Foxy not expecting that late hammer, probably expecting a shatter instead.
Now that's something that you've always needed to do against moves that are safe but not punishable. You know they're going to at least be blocking something after it. So going for that grab to enforce that, to make them want to press buttons, is something that can really help you out. But again, Fox is going to get that corner pressure. And in the back 1-2 grab, once again, hammer for the knockdown. Forward dash, ooh, into the back 2 this time, mixing it up.
Now, although there's an element of a 50-50 there, it's very smart that Sonic Fox went for that option, because he spent almost every single time enforcing that back 3 tick grab. That the second you go, right, well, I know he's going to do it now. Bam! Eat the overhead, and there you go. You're now guessing the 50-50 once again.
Out of the corner, but unfortunately it connects in a way that he's actually still there. And another nice tech from Sonic Fox. Very surprised the ice ball beat the anti-air, but he's going to take that, force the 2 bars out of Foxy to make him break. And another tech grab.
It's very hard to grab both of these players, I think. I mean, they're always so on point with their throw techs. I think that was definitely an attempt I think that was an attempt to try and maybe punish the shatter, but I think it is pretty safe in post-patch.
Nice block from Fox. Ooh, neutral crouches the throw, but doesn't quite punish it. That would have been an amazing defensive sequence from Sonic Fox. Unfortunate combo drop stops him getting out of the corner. Wake up down one, gonna get the plus frames into the confirm off the 1-1-1.
I think that corner combo drop's gonna be a bit of a heartbreaker for him, because I mean, the fact that Sonic Fox has now got all of this momentum, he's got the splat, and now he's got 2 bars. So even if he guesses wrong, which doesn't even matter, he's gonna get that teleport punish and take the next game. So in that situation, I think the new confirm with Buzzsaw is basically, if you're mid-screen, you can combo into spin, and then you do the straight hat into a dive kick, and that's going to be the sort of go-to.
Whereas very difficult as well. That's a very, very, very tricky conversion.
But if you're in the corner, you switch it. So you confirm into the straight hat, and then you do a down one into, I think, another back 3-2-1, and then you spin, as far as I'm aware. Like, it's, you kind of, depending whether you're mid-screen or in the corner, you will switch the order of which you do the hat and the spin. Nice. Sonic Fox, I think he's trying to go for back 1-2, down 1, back 1-2. But he's dropped it a few times, so it looks like he's actually gone for a slightly easier conversion just to get the consistent damage, which I completely agree with. Good trade for Sonic Fox. This is going to be mad corner carry, but Foxy having 2 bars of Mia is definitely going to break that.
Well, that's the token Foxy break. You know, as soon as you can do it, do it. Don't waste any time. Build that bar back. You've got all the time in the world to get it. But seeing Foxy already do a good job of shutting down the tick throw game. And even though Sonic Fox is teching grab after grab, it's not stopping Foxy from doing it anyway. He'll set up the heart to block. August gets out of there. Nice stuff from Sonic Fox.
Yeah, I mean, if you can just get out of range of the hat, that's going to be a nice way to deal with it. Foxy trying to do wake-up buttons, probably anticipating some kind of grab. However, he's going to get caught with a full combo there. This could even be death. Is he going to meter burn it? No, he's going to go for a splat into chip. A little bit riskier.
I would almost say that you're against a character like Lao, even if you've got the teleport, you're still guaranteed chip to a degree on a knockdown. I mean, if you do a down one to get it and he teleports, you're going to recover in time to hit him again anyway. So Fox already adapting to the fact that you can basically pressure Lao a lot more than you used to be able to. And you kind of need to, because he wants to stagger against you for days. So you need to knock him down and not let him have those defensive options.
Nice, and that's going to be another element there, just that grab being so fast and armored. So you can go for shatter, which is already going to make your opponent try and press a button because you think it's their turn to press a button. But if you've got that counter poke on the meter burn grab in the corner, that's max damage into more setup.
And that was 4 down 4s back to back. And when you're down, when your command grab ticks
slide
off down 4, that's when you're going to start seeing that.
Foxy seeing that he's got no bar, so it's more likely, but yeah, that's pretty much going to be game over right there. So I think I agree with Foxy pressing buttons after he blocked the shatter then, because Sonic Fox had no bar to enforce anything else, you know. So in that instance, you can understand why he made the decision he made, but Sonic Fox still going to be right in there, because I mean, Sub-Zero has a faster down one, which means that if he thinks you're going to press a button, he can catch you with that, and if the down one connects, bam, he's in a great position.
Oh, empty jump meter burn slide. No, he's going to go for the trip guard attempt. Creates the bar though, so still has a little bit. Well, no, I actually lost the health advantage, but at least got the first bar. Nice block on the back 2. Doesn't get a punish though.
Sonic Fox is absolutely not going to drop his punishes, and now Foxy's in the corner once again. Goes for the wake up. Nice coverage there. The faster down one again is only ever going to help Sub-Zero to punish that teleport, and that's going to be nice damage as well. I wonder if he's going to cash out or just splat it.
Yeah. Well, that is case in point what I was sort of describing in the last match. You know, if you down one Kung Lao in his wake up, his only armored move is the teleport. If it's a down one, you're going to recover in time for him to appear on the other side, and then you actually get a punish as well. So it's almost like a cover all the options.
Catches it again, let's not forget. Oh, does drop the combo, so Foxy, a little bit of a lifeline right here. He's going to enforce that mix-up. Sonic Fox, thinking that Foxy's going to stagger, isn't going to do it. Max damage right there, 30% damage.
Oh, nice, anti-air. Gets the hat back just in time, but Foxy doesn't go into the spin. I think he just wants to guarantee that knockdown to get the Oki. Oh, catching him.
I'd like to say that was actually a really, really nice read on the grab on hit. Sonic Fox confident that Foxy's going to try and grab, even after low hat connected. Could have eaten a full combo right there.
Meteor Burn low hat isn't plus anymore, so going to have to watch out. The Meteor Burn straight hat now gets the plus frames instead, but
I think
it's still like minus one. I'm not quite sure, but still, it's not plus anymore.
Foxy was actually ready for that confirm, going straight into spin. And again, just catching those nice little new confirms that you can see. And that's the Meteor Burn straight hat, which I think is plus four, isn't it?
Plus five, I believe, but don't hold me to that.
Something like that, around that
area.
We're
all learning, man. We're all learning these new moves.
Foxy's going to break to just deny any momentum, but he's got to be careful. Sonic Fox trying to hit confirm, thinking it might have caught in the corner. This, however, is kind of bad. He's not going to be able to go for the restand because he's already used an ice ball, but he's going to take this damage anyway. Going to go for a
splat.
Three bars of meter. Oh, that's it! Punished! Sonic Fox has to break! Oh, what a read. Oh, no!
This is the dive kick!
Oh, no!
Is he going to give this one away? I think Foxy might have just thrown this one away. Is he got enough damage to kill him?
Can he kill him? I think that's it. Oh, no. Not like this. Oh, no.
Oh, because he missed the dive kick. That is unfortunate. Is this like a 3-game lead now for Fox?
I think this is a 3-game lead, yeah. It's 5-2. And that's why, I mean, that's basically why you tighten your execution, you know? But in this stage, when everyone's learning new things, it's happened to Sonic Fox. It's happened to everyone.
It just happens to weaker players like us more than it does players like these.
Quiet you. Oh, nice trip guard on the standing one though. Foxy's going to catch that, aren't he? Does drop the combo.
Trip guard that got him the first hit bonus, so win-win for Foxy there. Oh, wow.
Wow.
1-1-1.
Yeah, that was a brave attempt, but Sonic Fox, his reads on these kind of interesting, I mean, sometimes you would almost think, is that a bad idea? You know, why would he do that? But it's Sonic Fox, you know, if the guy feels like you're going to do something, he's going to make that read, especially if he's got two bars.
That isn't the first time this set we've seen Fox wake up off of that specific knockdown, off of that ender, with buttons. Part of me thinks that he actually hasn't got much frames at all to get anything off it. I'd love to know if Lau's actually at hit advantage after that string.
Sonic Fox acknowledging that he's going to need setup here, so he's going to cash out damage early, take the back 1-2 restand, and here we go. Speaking of restands, he's going to do the exact same thing again. Forward 1-2, more plus. Goes for the tick grab. Foxy not ready for it. Oh, and he just ever so slightly gets the chip.
Okay, that's something. When you die standing up because you block, then you fall over anyway. Rip.
Yep. Foxy going to catch that confirm again. New corner confirm. He's now going to spin.
Oh, but misses dive kick.
Yeah, I think Sonic Fox was just too low down to the ground. Dive kick was going to whiff.
The issue is he cornered himself, right? Didn't get the confirm on that either, but at least he's forcing his way out of the corner. But this is Sub-Zero. One touch is going to put him straight back in again.
There you go, cancelling everything into Shatter just to give Sub-Zero the good frames that he always needed.
Oh,
I'm not sure I agree. Yeah, I'm not sure I agree with that break.
He must have been convinced he was going to turn it into Ice Ball instead of Hammer and had already committed to it by then. Oh, misses his combo as well. This sort of goes back to the new patch unfamiliarity, I suppose, when the guys aren't quite 100% with the new stuff, but they're getting there.
Yeah, I agree completely. Foxy's going to catch the grab, so I mean, a couple more grabs like that. Doesn't matter that Sonic Fox has Breaker, that damage is going to add up. He's looking like he's almost got an X-ray, so he's either going to use that X-ray to win the round, or he's going to spend a bar now. Oh! Oh, doesn't even have the chance. Foxy's going to take that third game on his tally. But I mean, Sonic Fox, you can agree with him being a little bit reckless right there, because if he went for like a reckless armor attempt, he, with three bars, would have had two bars to then break if his read was incorrect. If he was correct, he's now got two bars to finish him off with.
I really want to know what Sub-Zero Shatter is on block now, though, because we're not seeing it punished, but at the same time, like, I can't see it being safe.
I think
I wish I knew what it was.
Regular Shatter, I think, is minus five.
Really?
It's minus. I've been told, I mean, we need to check the patch notes, obviously, but I've been told it's around the minus five area, and when you are playing as Unbreakable and you have Aura, it's zero.
Interesting.
Oh, dropping the dive kick again. Probably should have just gone for a 2-1 right there.
I wonder if this could be the opening that Fox needs to make the comeback, though, because he's got the three bars, and this is Sonic Fox.
Here comes the back two.
Nice patience from Foxy. Is he going to get the full confirm? No, misses it once again.
Oh,
wow. A very un-Foxy finish, but I'm sure he'll take it.
A Fox finish, Caltrops. The Foxy finish, down one.
Oh wow.
Running at you. Foxy, gonna be ready for that.
I like how he did the combo there that didn't actually take any stamina either.
there's a lot of pokes going on. I like to point that out. There's a lot of down ones.
But part of me thinks that could be a direction the game is going. I know pokes were always a thing, but with armor being weaker and a lot of the pokes being sped up, and a lot of mids being nerfed, I wonder if pokes could become even more dangerous now than they were before.
Gets well, him to the ground with a down three.
Well, as you can see, Foxy's he's blocking the down one. He's expecting Fox to press a button. So he's going for a standing one on anticipation of that. But Sonic Fox is going for two down ones. He's going to go under that high.
Oh, that's a bad trade for Foxy. Going to get in the corner. Absolutely going to end up there.
I don't think it's going to kill.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow. It. Yeah, yeah. Drops to confirm. And now this is what Foxy needs. He's got X-ray. Is he going to do it? Oh, Fox is going to block it.
Oh, he throws his X-ray again. Again, he throws it away and loses the round.
I think when Foxy plays online, he likes using that X-ray. I think we can all agree on that.
Well, it's got a lot of utility. There's a lot you can do with it. It's just, it's the prophecy is fulfilled again. If you waste your X-ray, it doesn't matter what's happening in the round, you will lose the round. It is the prophecy, and it reigns true
Sonic
all the
Fox,
time.
We were talking about a couple of execution issues. You can tell both guys here are still getting used to their B&B. Sonic Fox consistently dropping back 1-2, down 1, back 1-2. And Foxy currently consistently dropping the dive kick 2. These look like some fiddly characters when you want to try and maximize their damage. Foxy, as you can hear in the background, goes for a little bit of a sigh right before the ice ball connects. He knows he's going to trade that.
Oh, doesn't spend the extra bar. Might live to regret that decision.
Oh my god!
Oh, Fox presses buttons. Actually doesn't want him to break. Nice finish from Foxy there.
Yeah, I definitely respect the idea that he left that string early before Sonic Fox had a chance to break anything right there. So, I mean, Foxy. God, why am I getting these guys confused? You can tell we haven't commentated in a while, man. Sonic Fox and
Foxy. It's almost like their names are very similar.
Warm up, Jake. Warm up. Here we go. It's going to be 4-5, almost completely even.
That string is actually fully punishable as well, so Foxy should be going for a full combo on there, but we'll take a grab at least to get the first hit.
Nice.
Very bad combo, unfortunately, Foxy.
Foxy's still in a good situation right here. Oh, I actually like that hit confirm. He saw the jumping connect, and instead of going for the kick or the grab like he normally does, seeing it connects, and then he commits into the launching strike.
Oh, straight into a back two. Wow, nice stuff from Sonic Fox.
I think Madsen calls that one an overhead.
Yep, that'll do. Ends in the grab. Wasayoki.
Tick grab. Nope, he's going to go for the straight up 50-50. This is the strength of Cryomancer. I mean, like the three hits. He touched him three times. And it's basically, I've gone for the splat, and now it's 50-50 or string into one of my many tick grabs. An extremely dangerous game to apply when the opponent's in the corner.
Oh, doesn't block that. Unfortunate for him. Oh, these low pokes into the tick grab. I think it's just a case of frustrating Foxy, you know, wanting him to block these pokes over and over and over again so you can then establish the command grab game. When you
Fox,
get one, 35%, 36.
Oh, he tick grabs it. There we go. Oh, another back two. Raw outright. Foxy's still in with a bit of a fighting chance, but he's definitely got a mountain to climb in this game. But this could be the start he needs. Sonic Fox tries to go for the dive kick, whiffs it, gets down four by accident. Ooh, another whiff though.
Playing like a maniac though, these slides.
And he gets caught by the overhead. This is definitely the hit that Foxy needs to try and pull this one back. Sonic Fox though, sitting on a bar. Is he going to use it on a reversal? Again, I think Foxy, I feel like it might be muscle memory. Like he's constantly trying to go for the plus frames right there. Oh, and he catches it. Anticipates that Sonic Fox is going to try and anti-air him. And he's 2-. Sonic Fox is going to tag him with that forward one all day and take his sixth game.
My video is having a lot of issues, by the way. I'm not sure if yours as well. Mine is stuttering a lot. So if I don't say anything for a couple of seconds, it's probably just trying to catch up with itself.
Mine's all right, to be fair. Mine's running smoothly. Quality-wise, though, this is taken from Foxy's stream, which isn't 100% optimal. So you might see a little bit of like blurriness on the video. But this is just purely because it's coming from a stream more than a video. Oh, another anti-air spin. Foxy is going to be consistently ready with that. He's going to go for the slightly lesser damaging ender, just try and get that splat. I don't really think he wants Sonic Fox to be anywhere further away than up close, because that seems to be where Foxy is extremely comfortable. Oh, and he catches a spin. Here comes Foxy. Whiffs it again, doesn't get the combo, but he still has got Sonic Fox in the corner, and this is exactly where he wants him to be. Sonic Fox sitting on 3 bars a meter can definitely make this happen. Speaking of which, catching that wake up, spinning 2 bars on the launcher. Nice. And there's a splat. Oh, and he blocks the spin. Oh no, doesn't go for an optimal punish. This could have killed him massively. Oh no. Oh no. Foxy.
Oh, that ain't good. That's not what you want.
Yeah, he punished it incorrectly right there, and Sonic Fox is going to make him punish for it all day. How easily you are defeated, Revenant, Kung Lao says. The smack talk from this man. Oh, and he catches it again. Sonic Fox Gets tagged away, sent full screen. Foxy's going to take away a comfortable 22% for that corner carry. Oh, wow. Nice hit confirmed. If you're a little bit behind, by the way, we can sync up with the time. I don't think it's too...
Yeah,
abysmal.
No worries. I think I'm just about caught up with you.
So, well, I'm currently... I'm not going to look at the timestamp just in case it gets in the way. Oh, no, again, Foxy not ready for the punishes. But the amount of life he's taken back, it's not a huge issue for him right now. I don't know what you're looking at right now, Muster, but I just saw a punish back too. Did you see the same?
I am, I believe, on the next match. I'm going to pause it.
Yeah. Give me the time
okay,
you're on.
Give me
the
second.
Time afterwards. We'll finish this one. Oh, and he catches the try, go for the tick grab. But that's going to be one of the dangers. If Sonic Fox is going to commit to a tick grab, but Foxy gets hit by the string, he's going to be ready to whip punish. Oh, and again, speaking of whip punishes, catch him in the air. This could be a 5-6 if Foxy just keeps it together. Good use of the reversal there from Sonic Fox. Again, committing into the back three tick throw, but Foxy getting tagged by the back three. And that's all the damage he wants. Oh, very clutch, running underneath the meaty burn hat right there. Sonic Fox only needs one more hit, tags the back two. He's going to go for a splat. Is he going to go for a splat damage? Oh, nice. Pretty clutch there from Foxy. Let's quickly pause the game.
What is your set currently at?
I am on... Let me quickly pause this. Sorry, guys. I am on 30 and 28. 30-28. Are you on there?
I will.
I think we'll probably need to have... Maybe we'll download
okay.
these
Ryan,
in the future.
Play it on 3, 2, 1 now.
Okay, cool. So Foxy's winning. This is his win pose. He's just won
yep.
the game.
Kung Lao wins.
There we go. It's like nothing ever happened. Don't worry about it. I think we need to have a more practical way of doing this in the future, but now this will have to suffice. So... Foxy's just taken that next game. He got the clutch grab attempt. Sonic Fox probably waiting for a strike or something else to whiff punish, but it's not going to work out. And it's now going to be 6-5. But Foxy securing that first hit bonus. And again, another anti-air spin. That's probably going to be, I think, Foxy's go-to anti-air now. Anti-airs have been buffed. And also that the armor on meter burn spin is gone. You're going to have to just time regular spin much better.
Oh, wow. Run up back too. Brave stuff from Sonic Fox, but he will take that. Has the corner already. Nice tick grab. Foxy's starting to get hit by those again.
Ooh! That's quite brave, but he's going to go in, challenge that with a mid. Hit confirm into spin. Does drop the combo, but again, enforcing that you're ready for the whiff punish is very dangerous. Ooh! That was a bit of a messed up hit confirm, I think, from Sonic Fox. But he's not going to mess that one up. Full combo. And here comes Cryomancer in the corner. Ooh, a reset! Cheeky!
Oh wow, grabs another good throwing tech from Sonic Fox.
Yeah, round number one, going to go to Sonic Fox. There's a couple of combo drops here. You can tell that they're still, I mean, we've said this before, right? They're still feeling out what they're going to be doing. So execution definitely isn't optimal, but it's day two, so. Yeah, and that's going to be one of the strengths. I mean, there is going to be a gap in between the shatter, but I'm really not sure how well Kung Lao is going to be able to capitalize on those gaps.
Well, I could see the shatter recovering before the teleport attack actually comes out. I mean, that's just a theory thing, but I don't see Kung Lao armor being a consistent way to deal with that.
Well, I mean, pre-patched, Kung Lao would have just meter burn spanned that, you know, and that would have been a crucial, crucial part of the matchup. But in this instance, he's not going to quite get it. And, I mean, that tool is no longer a possibility. Confirmed from Foxy again. Obstacle, nice up close. Two backdashes! Doesn't get
wow.
the punish! Oh!
I love the double backdash, though. The only thing that will get him out of that chip in that situation, he did it. Wonderful play.
Well, it was really smart from both players. Foxy ending the combo early because he was going to try and secure it with chip damage up close because Sonic Fox didn't have the health to trade with armor either. So Sonic Fox doing the only thing he could have done, which was two backdashes just to get out of dodge, but he's going to take the round anyway.
You know? Rare footage of a Kung Lao down three.
Yeah. What is that? I've never seen that normal before. Madness.
Stamina-less combo at the end. 31%. Nice stuff. Just a bit of stamina to get in. Has to be careful getting touched here. Oh, Sonic Fox holding on to all this meter though. Is he going to break? Surely he has to break. No, he's holding on to it.
I think he's confident. I mean, this is Cryomancer in the corner. He has to break now though. It might
block
even
break,
be too
block
late.
Block break! Must block break! No, saves it for the slide.
Oh!
No, still alive.
No, oh. He's going to jump into the hat and die. 6-6 now. 6-6.
A very, again, uncommon situation of being a commentator and having to say, use the block breaker.
Especially
it would
seeing
work
as,
in this situation.
Especially seeing as the patch hasn't actually changed block breakers either.
Exactly. I guess he thought, well, I mean, I'd rather take it on block and have the meter to get the launcher from the grab or, you know, make it
Whoa,
hurt with the damage.
That PND though.
Oh, nice down one. Unfortunately, another combo drop just look at the damage it didn't do. Wonderful whiff punish on the spin. I like how he waited just enough time to make sure he didn't accidentally just run into the spin.
Sonic Fox unfortunately going to drop that conversion once again. So I think he's either going to keep trying to do it because they're just playing online. He's going to try and adapt and go for a slightly different conversion. Speaking of which, Foxy dropping his conversion also. Oh, nice punish. Again, though, Foxy trying to go for a certain string and just going for the spin too early. I think he's just trying to go for these little conversions that he's just not used to doing. Sonic Fox, again, speaking of which, lots of drops coming from both of these players right now.
Oh, spends the bar, wants to go for the kill. Is that enough damage? Surely it is.
Yeah, absolutely, because that hammer adds a massive chunk every single time. And even then, he'd have gone for the splat into guaranteed chip, so game over.
Oh, wow, clean jump out of the corner. Unorthodox way and a risky way of getting out, but it worked in that situation. He knew Sonic Fox was going to go for something. Oh, combos off it. No, doesn't get the full confirm. That's highly unfortunate for him.
Well, I think that actually would have worked if Sonic Fox was on the ground, but because he was airborne, it just altered how long he was in the air. Because he's already in the air, it's going to change the gravity quite substantially.
Oh, armored again. Sonic Fox always good with the armor. Since day one, he's just been so good with knowing when to counterpoke with that.
I think it's just his reads on when to counterpoke with armor are just so on point all the time, you know? Oh, the anti-air attempt! That would have been sick if it worked. That would have been really, really sick if it worked. But Sonic Fox is going to catch it and whiff punish anyway. But the round is going to go to Foxy. So whoever's going to take their seventh game lies in this next round.
You don't normally see Foxy do that, you know, sort of, I don't want to say scramble for pokes, but go for the poke for that first hit of the round. But with the speed in which all of Sub-Zero's best low pokes are at now, you kind of need to as Lau, it seems.
And he's going to cash out. Hasn't used a freeze yet, so he's going to go for the restand. Catches the free 50-50. One of the strengths that Crymance has always had is going for that string into meter burn. Oh, and he tries to cash out. This could be a comeback for Foxy, but Sonic Fox has a lot of life to work with, and it's going to be even
meter
harder
slide.
Now.
Yeah. And wow, that's a token Sub-Zero finish in Crymancer. Anyone that's played ranked and fought Crymancer has seen that one all too many times before.
Yeah. You can say that again. You can say that again.
Because it works, you know, in a situation where blocking the slide is death and they delay the wake up, you know, just slide. They block it,
well,
dead.
I mean,
if you've got the life and the breaker to work with, then.
Well, I mean,
like,
if you're confident that Kung Lao's not going to go for a meaty back three, because he's had to run in, so it's unlikely he's going to run into back three, because there is significant startup time on that. So he's more likely he's going to run in with a standing one, which is a high, which will lose to wake up slide. Oh no, he gets hit by the back two again. One of Sub-Zero's strengths now, I think, is that many characters in the game had lost their 50-50s, but although of all the buffs Sub-Zero received, he completely retained the speed of both his overhead and his low. So there's always going to be a guess there. Oh, the delay, trying to shoot
the grab. But as you've seen over and over again, Lau does get a very consistent punish on the back two, so it's still not as much of a good option. Oh, Meebun spin being used post-patch.
Well,
almost,
I mean,
if it still has its uses as a six-frame launcher.
That's definitely, oh, we have something.
Was it seven frames?
That never happened, don't worry. Something appeared on the screen from Twitch. We will ignore that. Foxy's going to take the next round. So I think that's actually going to be one of the things. Although you've lost the armor, you're still going to keep the consistent punish of the speed and launching properties of Meteor Burn Spin.
I'm pretty sure it's 7 frames. It's definitely not 6.
I think it's 7 frames, yeah.
Keyword being think, don't you worry. We will look into this.
I remember pre-patch when Tempest's Meteor Burn Spin was 4 frames.
I remember this also.
That was just one whole meme, wasn't it? One big meme.
Never forget. But Foxy really are doing a good job of establishing the control in this game so far. I mean, even though Fox is blocking a lot, he's building a lot of bar for Foxy, so he's kind of content with just slowly chipping him away, because he's got the breaker now, he can be risky. Or he's got the meter burn teleport to kill. Or he can trade the bar with Sonic Fox. He's got a lot of options now.
Smart use of that instant air dive kick to get out of the corner, but that entire sequence of block strings, Sonic Fox has built a ton of meter. He can definitely keep this round going. He just needs one single hit, and then he'll be good to go. Run into down four, just trying to check him. Oh, and a jump back from Foxy, and again.
Oh, because he ran in, didn't
yeah,
have
the stamina change. Stamina change right there. Sonic Fox ran in, got tagged, and lost an entire block of stamina. And because of that, Foxy's jump back was not only successful, but Sonic Fox had no stamina. He had the meter to break, but he didn't have the stamina because of that stamina change.
We're sitting at 7-7. When we said this was a close set, we meant it.
Yep, we did indeed. Foxy, goddamn. Oh, we'll stop making this mistake. He's going to get the first hit, and he's going to take that nice grab. And speaking of grabs, that was just an interesting time to get one.
Extra throw this time.
Oh,
they're all down ones after it, though.
Yeah, I think Sonic Fox, he's never afraid to poke. Because if he gets a poke as Crymancer, like, he's going to be able to enforce the whole mix-up game. You know, he's going to be able to enforce the tick grabs. He's going to be able to enforce the 50-50. It's all going to start off a down four. Oh, wow. Ape Man brave slide.
Neutral.
Very brave. Now, I wonder if that was a guaranteed punish or whether Sonic Fox pressed a button.
Oh, wow. Slide straight into it. That wasn't even meter burn.
Oh, the buffer.
Fox is just feeling himself, but that's why.
I'd like to really just bring attention to that amazing 1-1-1 ice ball buffer. That was only the 1-1-1 was only going to connect from that range if Foxy walked into the final hit of 1-1-1, of which Sonic Fox was ready and had already buffered into ice ball just in case. Very smart stuff.
Oh wow, down one's after it. You know you get the down one when your opponent's waiting for you to finish the string. And he has the low hat. Used all of his stamina to run in that short distance, but has built it back with just a single throw.
He's going to go in for Shatter. Brave, and he's confident, I think, that without two bars, Foxy's unlikely to try and do anything about the gap between the string and the Shatter. A lot of patience right there. Nice fuzzy guard there on the overhead. I mean, you can still fuzzy that hammer all day. That's not really a mix-up.
Now, normally Foxy will always opt to go for the Kung Lao down four off a throw tech, but Buzzsaw, he gets that extra element of going for the low hat sometimes instead.
Oh my god, Magna Arms!
Wow. Oh my word, long arm of the Cryomancer.
He's going to be able to enforce this, might get enough chip, instant jump back dive kick. I mean, I understand Sonic Fox going for that because he's minus, but I mean, it would have been risky to try anything else, and he was probably going to lose the round anyway. Foxy having Sonic Fox in the corner, but it's very risky. He gets tagged one time.
Oh, wow.
Sonic Fox, and I was just about to say, has him in the corner with two bars as Cryomancer, and now it's looking pretty bad. He's going to go for a splat. The question is, what's the Oki? Is he going to tick grab or 50-50? Good escape there from Foxy. Made the right guess. He's going to try and punish the ice ball. Sonic Fox just thinking Foxy was going to take damage. Foxy going for the slightly earlier ender. Goes for two grabs. Isn't going to work, but Sonic Fox is going to catch him with a grab of his own.
Delays the throw again. Really just trying to mix up Foxy again. Tries to wait a cut back dash, doesn't work. Oh, and the down one again. There's the meat and teleport, burns two bars, trades two bars for two bars, but Foxy's still down on life. Nice reactions from Sonic Fox with a slide, meat on a spin.
That
great
was
stuff.
That was a Mortal Kombat 9 slide right there.
That was options within, and Foxy went for it, and it worked, but fortunately Sonic Fox is still going to take it 8-7 in this set so far.
It's going pretty well. I think if this were live, we would be talking about how much of an insanely close set this one is, because it is a good one. You can see what both variations are now capable of. You know, you've got the small little conversions, but the pressure and the screen dominance of Buzzsaw, but the absolute relentless rushdown of Cryomancer. But Kung Lao still having some fundamental stuff that he likes, you know. I've got a feeling that those double spins are a mistake. I don't think Foxy's actually planning on doing them. Because every time he gets the two spins, you can actually hear him go, damn, you know, where he knows that he's made an error there. I'm guessing it's just something to do with the new strings that he's trying to end the combos with.
Oh, wow. Taking the motion on no stamina, goes to forward dash into a grab.
Too far away. Yeah, he's too far away. I think he's too far away for that one. The down one again, very strong. If he thinks that Foxy's going to pressure, nice, neutral jump. I think that's actually the first time in all of these games that Sonic Fox has gone for that option. He's not going to convert off back two because he hasn't got the stamina to follow up, but it doesn't even matter. He's going to take that first round.
Now we can see Foxy consistently try to grab or do stuff that is making the read that Sonic Fox is going to block after Shatter. And if there's one thing Sonic Fox is not doing, it's blocking after Shatter. He's backdashing, he's neutral jumping, he's down one-ing. But it's kind of up to Foxy to look for an option to stop that now instead.
I wonder if it's just a complete game of rock, paper, scissors as to what Sub-Zero is going to do after he's done that down one. Oh, sorry, after he's done the Shatter, sorry.
Or she misses that combo again.
There we go. He's not going to drop it this time. One forward dash, recovers in time. Oh, I think Sonic Fox again trying to buffer it.
That was like a max distance 1-1 punish on that. Awesome stuff.
One round apiece again. But Sonic Fox definitely has the meter advantage, and Cryomancer with that, he's going to massively hurt. Tries to confirm into that. I wonder if that was a meter burn attempt that just didn't come out.
Maybe, but I'm sure it was a trip guard. He saw him with the jump in, went straight for the forward four. Sonic Fox reaction's always on point. A nice throw tech again. There's the Shatter. Oh, blocks after the Shatter this time. The read finally works.
You wonder if next time he does Shower Unblock, Foxy's going to call the bluff and do something that isn't grab.
Guess we'll find out. Oh, gets to jump in. Oh, whiffs the grab and a full punish, but forced to break as Foxy keeps himself topped up on the life lead, but now severely down on bar.
Foxy's definitely trying to keep this mid-screen game, especially with Sonic Fox sitting on three bars. He does not want to be anywhere near that corner.
Oh,
for the whip punish.
I didn't even know you could tick grab off standing too.
Yeah, he's got, I think, 8 or 9 tick grabs, I think.
That's,
wow!
Excessive.
That was rather brave.
Oh, doesn't get the full punish.
Oh, that was risky.
Gets that this time, though.
I wonder if the dropped punish... I don't want to say dropped, but I wonder if he just did the forward 2 by itself because he probably anticipated that Sonic Fox is going to go for the break and he didn't want the break.
I can see that.
Probably the most likely scenario right there, but it's 8 games to both players.
Oh my word. Fight for that first hit goes to Foxy again. Foxy's getting most of the first hits, but isn't getting quite as much out of his bar as Sonic Fox is right now.
Drops to confirm, but again, every time Foxy drops to confirm, Sonic Fox seems to get tagged anyway, you know, where it kind of just seems like it doesn't really matter. Speaking of which, catches the overhead, nice confirm right there on Foxy, doesn't get the knockdown, but has Sonic Fox in the corner. Sonic Fox definitely not going to block anymore, does not want to give Foxy any more meter, especially seeing as now he's got max.
Very demanding round from Foxy right now, but is in the corner, but there's a down one. As soon as that down one connected, that was it, that was curtains for round one. Foxy's sitting on three bars, but Sonic Fox almost got that himself, and he does have the corner.
This means
we've seen that, you know, Cryo can already kill you in 3 touches, especially when Sonic Fox is doing the right conversions, like this one we might be able to see. And there's the break to trade the bar.
Oh, wow! Now that small step back was Sonic Fox attempting to trip guard that jump, Foxy catching onto it, and just tagging it with the sheer range of the jump too.
Oh, tries to do a little bit of a shimmy with the back three. Doesn't quite get the max payout for it though, and a nice punish on the full string. Sonic Fox is holding onto the breaker once again, he wants to flip him round.
And he has done just that. Oh no, I think that was an attempt. Foxy, oh wow, hang on, not ready for the confirm. We have another scramble on our hands, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes Foxy, gets the grab. Sonic Fox though, again, sitting on two bars, can absolutely pull this round back if he just gets a good reversal. But at this point, it's not going to matter. And Foxy is now going to be one game up and one game away from winning the set.
Wow, that's actually a good point. He's basically lost a couple of games and has been slowly but surely catching up in games. But as he's caught up, Sonic Fox has been pulling ahead. But now for the first time in the set, we can see Foxy is actually sitting one game up. That's awesome. But Sonic Fox, you know, he's only got 2 games left to pull it back and meet a certainly a spin. Foxy is playing on point at the moment. It's just that token patience.
Get a tag, another grab. Sonic Fox sitting on a bar. Now, I wonder if, from that far away, I wonder if Kung Lao can punish it. I'm assuming so, but you would need to be ready for a different conversion, I think. Or just a different button.
Speaking of conversion, I do like the way he hit confirm the forward 1-2 into ice ball. Nice stuff there. Oh, and a tick grab as well, as soon as he knows he's been doing the ice balls.
Well, you're watching Sonic Fox play Cryomancer, you'd think he's played it this entire time.
That's just Sonic Fox. You know, when you are that good at this game and you have used so many characters since day one, you can just pick up a character and just make it your own. And that's exactly what Sonic Fox is doing with Cryo right now.
Foxy having nothing to lose. He's going to go for the regular spin, but Sonic Fox calling that bluff.
Nothing to lose but the round.
Well, you know, I mean, he's dead anyway, isn't he? That's why he went for it.
I hear you. Oh, wow. Interesting trade.
Oh! Whiffing left, right, and center. Here we go. Sonic Fox again going into Shatter just to just give Sub-Zero those good frames. You know, that's one of the changes he's been given. Is that he's got good frames now. Tick grab. Here we go.
Yeah, by this point, I can see Foxy sitting there in his chair thinking to himself, gee, is there anything that this isn't going to tick grab off?
And there we go, noticing he hasn't gone for the ice ball, so now he's going to go for the reset. But again, Sonic Fox committing to the 50-50. I completely respect it, because if he got the 50-50, that would have been game over. But it has given Foxy that chance to come back. He's confident Sonic Fox isn't going to go for a wake-up attack. Here comes the pressure, gets the double overhead. Good block from Sonic Fox, and he gets down one again. Could be game over for Foxy if he gets tagged one more time. But
gets the grab and the neutral again.
Yep, that's it. Sonic Fox on the ropes.
Oh wow, misses to confirm, but gets a little bit of chip damage. They have a match point to the set to Foxy right now. One match away, one round away. I'm taking it 10-8, but again, I mean, we've seen all Sonic Fox has to do is put you in the corner, and he could just take it just like that.
One string at a time as well, pushing Foxy further away. Very crucial throw take, and a nice trip guard on the neutral crouch into 1-1-1 freeze.
Now, can we just talk about for a second how Sonic Fox pushed Foxy halfway to the corner with block strings?
Yep. Here we go.
Just really, really just... Cryomancer's a threat now, man. He is super dangerous.
Lots of jumps, a lot of downfalls, and he's going to punish that teleport. He's definitely not going to drop this combo, and it's going to be 9 games each. Foxy and Sonic Fox.
Doesn't drop it this time. Just tries to. It just turns the down one into the grab this time instead of going for the full follow-up, but if you don't need it to win, why waste the opportunity to take the game?
So this is pretty close, you could probably say. These guys are now one game away from taking this.
It's 9-9. It's obviously close.
I'd like to apologize for a couple of things that might occasionally pop into the screen, guys. Again, I'm screen capturing from a web page, so it's not ideal. We should probably download the video next time.
My solution to that is let's start doing it live. You know, let's get players in and record their games and sets live instead of over VODs. Let's make sure, you know, stream it ourselves, record it ourselves, whatever.
Oh yeah, that's definitely what I plan to do. A nice throw tech from Sonic Fox. He's gonna confirm on block, and here we go. Here comes another shatter. Back to black. Counter poking into meter band slide, and just like that, these guys are almost dead even, almost completely even super meter.
That's another special that Foxy's managed to avoid by jumping back. So that's currently the shatter, the grab, and the hammer that are all going to miss if you jump back. I wonder if you've got wonderful, like really good air mobility, if that's a legitimate answer to blocking Cryomancer, is jumping back.
Here comes Sonic Fox. Wake up down one is going to tag that command grab. Oh my god, this is definitely a scramble. Here comes Foxy, and he's going to go straight into the X-ray. And Sonic Fox, is this going to kill? Not quite.
Not quite, but again, the slide. Looking for it. There it
is. Oh no!
The dive kick's gonna miss, taking Sonic Fox to reverse set point instead. But no bar though. Foxy's sitting on 3 bars. That's all he needs.
The down one, and there we go. That's gonna make that command grab connect. He's gonna get a respectable 13% into splat. Foxy has him in the corner. This is absolutely gonna corner carry, and that's gonna do good damage. Wow, 34% for no bar.
Oh, tries to go for the grab, but doesn't actually waste the second bar though, because it misses. Oh wow, went straight into a jump kick.
That jump kick was definitely a good choice from Fox. He's got a bar. Oh, he's going to go for meterless slide. Very brave. And he's going to confirm Foxy is going to have to break. Oh, hang on. An unbreakable attempt. Wake up X-ray. Okay, so.
Is that going to be enough to kill?
I think so. Yeah, he's dead. So round one goes to Sonic Fox X-ray. Round two is going to go to Foxy's X-ray. So it could be match point. Both players 9-9. This could not be any closer.
Have you guys figured out why we chose this set yet?
Shh, don't ruin it. You're going to get the grab. Here we go. Oh, nice. Hit confirm. That's going to be one more grab. Moment to freeze. That's going to corner carry for days.
Nice. 29%. Doesn't get the grab, but gets the corner positioning. That's exactly what he needs. Now, this is bad for Foxy, because Sonic Fox is in the driver's seat. He's got the corner positioning. He's got loads of bar. He's got the breaker, but drops the combo. Foxy's going to wake up instead and get a full punish. Oh, drops the ender though.
No tick grab from Sonic Fox. He's not going to take that risk. He's sitting on another X-ray and he might kill at this health. He'll only need a couple more hits to make it so. Oh, a running grab!
Oh my word. It's going down to the wire.
The next play is going to take this set.
Both of them potentially one hit away. Uses the bar, hasn't got the X-ray anymore. There's the teleport block though. Scoured out. And there's the meat bun slide. Trading hit.
Oh! Crushing defeat. No pun intended. So,
pun fully intended. Don't even lie.
Yeah, maybe. And that's going to be it. Sonic Fox are going to take it 10-9. They're going to switch characters. I'm going to give this a pause now. And we're going to call that there. I'm going to play it so we have at least the background. I think they changed to Tempest versus Katana, I think. But
so
I don't know how that
basically,
one went.
That's why we picked that set, guys. Super close, awesome display, newly buffed Buzzsaw versus newly buffed Cryo. It's Sonic Fox versus Foxy, which never fails to deliver. And hopefully you enjoyed it. You know, we have been looking for opportunities to do this kind of thing again. And I mean, I'm sure I can speak for us both. We had a lot of fun doing this just now. And we'd love to do more of them. To clean it up in the future, if this is something you folks enjoyed, let us know. We will be able to improve it by doing sets live. We've got a couple of European players that want to have sets of messages like, you know, we'd love to play against each other. Can you commentate it and stuff? I guess similar to Pig's Red Hot Sundays, but not as much of a event, not as much of a main event style, you know, grudge match and stuff. Kind of just high level play with actual commentary. And that's kind of what we want to go for, you know. So I don't want to step on Pig's toes there. But that's kind of what we're looking to provide you guys, if it's something you enjoyed, obviously.
So, all budget production aside, hopefully you guys enjoyed that one. Like I said, we knew the outcome because we had watched the final game before, but all of those other games we actually hadn't seen. We just knew it went 10-9, we knew it was close, and we were like, you know what? I want to watch this and I want to commentate this set. And that's exactly what we've done. So again, hopefully the audio levels are okay. Hopefully it's all good to go. This was definitely a first for us. And by all means, let us know if you'd like more. And we definitely will deliver that. So thank you very much for watching. We'll catch you next time and we'll see you later.